popular opinion, everyone, but I think Tangled is a much better movie than Frozen. I might be crazy, but hear me out. I'm going to do a category by category comparison and settle this debate once and for all. Frozen has made $1.2 billion and won 2 Academy Awards for Best Animated Feature and Best Original Song for Let It Go. Meanwhile, Tangled has earned almost $600 million and was nominated for 7 awards, but only won 1 award for Best Original Song for I See the Light. As much as I love Tangled, even I cannot deny how successful Frozen was. Point goes to Frozen. For me, the thing I look forward to the most with Disney movies is the music. Tangled songs fit the story really well, but unfortunately, they all sound the same to me, except for I See the Light. While Frozen's songs were great outside of the story, more on that later. The songs in Tangled are more creative, taking inspiration from folk rock music, while Frozen's feels more like a generic Broadway musical. The one song I feel is downright annoying is In Summer, sung by Olaf. This is because it doesn't need to be a song. It isn't a big and important thing, like A Friend Like Me from Aladdin, and could just be getting across with a few words of dialogue or a quick scene. At the end, I don't know who should get the point, so we'll call it a draw. When the songwriters wrote Let It Go, they decided to make Elsa the hero instead of the villain, making all the characters not completely fleshed out with each one except for Elsa, giving one basic character trait and thinking that will carry the movie. Elsa and Let It Go was one of the many reasons why Frozen became most people's favorite Disney movie. But for me personally, I think we all let Elsa and Let It Go to our heads and let that create our opinion for the whole movie. Let It Go works great as a song by itself, but when you take into account that this is a musical with a story, it completely ruins it. The song is very similar to The Lion King, Hakuna Matata, with the main character running away from home and their responsibilities. Except, in that movie, there was one crucial scene that completely changes the meaning of that song, where Mufasa appears to his son Simba in this beautiful animated night sky, where he accepts that his duty is with his pride and that he must take his place in the circle of life. But Frozen never gives Elsa that honor. Instead, she is forced to come back and fix her mistake, and furthermore, should not have become queen after abandoning her people. Meanwhile, Rapunzel is a far more interesting character, with her being a pushover for her mom and wanting to see what's outside her tower. Elsa doesn't have any wants or desires of her own. She's just moping around feeling she will hurt someone with her powers. Rapunzel also just feels more relatable to me, since the focus is on her being a pushover and her relationship with her mother. Prince Hans is the stupidest twist villain and should have come with Anna to rescue Elsa. We even cut back to Arendelle, and Hans is not doing anything evil, and is helping the kingdom stay warm after Elsa gave them an eternal winter. His character also messes up the song, Love is an Open Door, which again is a fine song by itself, but is nothing more than a lie in the story. This could have easily been fixed by giving Love is an Open Door to Anna and Kristoff and giving Hans a new villain song, setting up his reveal as the villain. Mother Gothel is a pretty decent to villain that has much more of a stake in the story, always trying to find Rapunzel and lure her back to her tower. Her being the villain also adds a really interesting conflict with Rapunzel's journey and even strengthens the relationship between Flynn and Rapunzel. The one thing I find questionable about her character is that there was a deleted opening where she was the one who grew the magic flower that gave Rapunzel the magic hair, and the king stole it from her, making her seem more sympathetic. Point goes to Tangled. Flynn Rider has a lot more charm and personality than Kristoff, who is just a stereotypical loner who talks to his reindeer like a crazy person. The ending of Tangled pays off Flynn's character arc in a beautiful way. In a beautiful scene that was perfectly set up, with Flynn sacrificing himself, saying that Rapunzel was his new dream, and making up for all the lying and deceiving of Rapunzel. Kristoff doesn't really grow or learn in any meaningful way. Instead, they just use him for exposition and to spell out Anna's character arc. Point goes to Tangled. These two films have drastically different sidekicks, with one of them being upbeat and naive, and the other one being the exact opposite. Olaf is one of the most annoying sidekicks, and that is because he has no reason to be in the movie. He has no reason to be in the movie and has no arc or journey of his own. Meanwhile, Maximus has his own journey with his growing relationship with Flynn, leading to a pretty cool action scene where he has to escape the castle to save Rapunzel, and we get the amazing revelation that it was Maximus that helped Flynn escape. Olaf just has the same joke about him being oblivious that he is a snowman and can melt. Whereas Maximus has so much more jokes than just the same predictable class. We get jokes about him and Flynn fighting each other without Rapunzel knowing. We get jokes about Maximus's uptight front. Finally, I think Maximus is better because he doesn't have to carry the role of comic relief by himself. Both stories are retellings of classic fairy tales, being Rapunzel by Jacob Grimm and The Snow Queen by Hans Christian Andersen. Frozen's story is a lot more mean-spirited, with both of Elsa's parents basically shunning their daughter from the world and making her scared of her ice powers. The movie is also much slower paced than Tangled, with it almost taking the whole movie to get to Elsa, only for her to not want to go home with them. The story is kind of like Toy Story 2. If Woody decided to go to Japan and just lucked his way back to Andy's. It's missing that moment with Elsa, reflecting on her choice to isolate herself from the world. After Elsa runs away, she has nothing to do until the end, where she saves Anna and says what she learned about love without us seeing her learn that lesson. I hate to draw another comparison to Pixar, but how satisfying would it be if we didn't see Nemo after he got taken to Sydney, and then at the end he tells his father he can do this? Tangled also tells a road trip story. However, the way they do it is much more satisfying, as we actually get to see the couple fall in love in some pretty cute scenes. I've mentioned in this video, the scene where she finally stands up for herself is much better since we actually get to see her come to this conclusion. The one thing I love most about Tangled's story is how each scene is building up to a bigger and bigger moment, until the biggest moment at the end. Once again, point goes to Tangled. Frozen's animation has less of an artistic art style, but looks more colorful and pops off the screen, especially with the animation of Elsa's ice palace. Tangled has more of a stylized look, taking inspiration from a painting, The Swing, from Jean-Juan Ferrand, making it feel more unique. However, this movie has its own problem, with most of the scenes taking place in the forest, making the sets kind of feel the same. When we are not in the forest, the colors look drab and just don't pop as well as Frozen. This point goes to Frozen. However, I would still like to give half a point to Tangled for its unique animation style you could only see in this movie. The better movie depends on what you're looking for. If you're looking for a deeper story with better characters, I would say Tangled is better. However, if you're looking for a more generic Broadway musical with great animation, I would say Frozen is better. As for me, I think I still prefer Tangled a little bit better, but Frozen is really not nearly as bad as I once thought. That's all for now, everybody. Stay tuned for more videos coming soon. Please like and subscribe. And let me know in the comments below what other movies you'd like me to take a look at.